Hi, in this video I'm going to be solving problem 1.6.5s in the Mathematics of Investment and Credit by Samuel A. Broverman, the 6th edition, is this book. We will be finding the interest earned in a time period when we are given a force of interest. So here we go. Ernie makes two deposits, a deposit of 100 at time 0 and a deposit of x at time 3. The fund grows at a force of interest equal to this function here. It's not a constant force of interest. Constant forces of interest give you exponential growth. This is positive increasing fairly rapidly. This is definitely going to give you faster than exponential growth. The amount of interest earned from time 3 to time 6 is x. So x is showing up in two ways in this problem, both as a deposit at time 3 and the amount of interest earned overall from time 3 to time 6. The goal is to calculate x. We haven't made a number line in a while, so let's go ahead and do that. Here, let's make a number line. Three relevant times, time 0, time 3, and time 6. You've got a deposit of 100 at time 0 and of x at time 3. What does it mean to grow according to a force of interest? I'm just going to tell you. It's something you should look up if you've forgotten. For example, it means this 100 deposit at time 0 will grow to 100 times e to the integral of the force of interest from time 0 to time 3. Integral from 0 to 3 of delta sub t, the force of interest. It also means at time 6, that initial 100 will grow to 100 times e to the integral of the force of interest from time 0 to time 6. That's what it means to have that force of interest. That's how that money grows. What about x? X is also growing according to the same force of interest, but it's starting at time 3 rather than time 0, and therefore you multiply x by e to the integral, not from 0 to 6, but instead from 3 to 6. It's a 3 down there if it's difficult to see. Integral from 3 to 6 of the force of interest. So once I find these quantities, these integrals, and multiply these by 100, I can find the total interest earned from time 3 to time 6 by taking this quantity minus this one and adding this quantity minus this one. Set that equal to x, then solve the resulting equation for x. Let's do the integrals first. So what about the integral from 0 to 3? Here's our force of interest, t squared over 100. Antiderivative is going to be t cubed over 300. That needs to get evaluated from 0 to 3. It's going to give you 27 over 300 minus 0, which is the same as 9 over 100, or 0.09. The integral from 0 to 6, think about it. It's going to give you the same antiderivative. From 0 to 6, you're going to get 6 cubed over 300 minus 0. That'll be 216 over 300, which equals 72 over 100, which can be reduced further, but you don't have to. Let's just write that as a 0.72. The integral from 3 to 6 is going to give you 216 over 300. Minus 27 over 300, or if you prefer, 0.72 minus 0.09, it equals 0.63. I need to exponentiate those things. I've got e to those integrals. Let's use a different color. We'll use our calculator here. So e to the integral from 0 to 3 is e to the 0.09. Type in 0.09. Then my e function is above the ln. I've got to use the second function key. E to the 0.09 is about 1.094174284, and I think I'll use all my decimals this time, just playing it safe. I also need e to the 0.72. My 0.72 second gives you 2.054433211. I also need e to the 0.63. That will be 1.877610579. And now I'm ready to set up my equation. Think back up here. This minus this, what's that going to be? That's going to be, this was e to that integral, which was this quantity here. 1.877610579 times x minus x. That difference will be the interest earned on the deposit of x at time 3 to time 6. Add on to that the interest earned by the initial 100 deposit from time 3 to time 6, this minus this. That's going to be 205.443321 minus, looking here, multiply that by 100, 109.4174284. I'm sure I could get away with fewer decimals, but I've already started this many, so I'll continue. Set this equal to x, because you're told that the amount of interest earned from time 3 to time 6 is x. This is our equation to solve for x. 205.443321 minus 109.4174284. Yep, okay. Gives you 996.02. This is going to be 0.877610579x. Subtract that from both sides, you're going to get 96.0258927 equals x minus that times x. Let's go ahead and store this 96. Take 1 minus 0.877610579 gives you 0.122389421x. Now divide both sides by that. So I'm going to take its reciprocal and multiply what I have stored in register 0. There we go. Finally, there's the answer. X is 784.59. And that is correct. And I'll end the video with that.